from here.
Okay.
Good. Amen.
Amen.
We come to celebrate. I said we come to celebrate. First Baptist, we come to celebrate. First Baptist, we come to celebrate. Somebody hear me. First Baptist, we come to celebrate. We come to celebrate. In the blessing from God. I ask you to stand to your feet. All over this house. As we receive the honor stained pastor, Dr. T. N. Miller.
hand. I want you to give the pastor another hand clap. And for you all who are streaming in and looking in, too bad you should have been here. But we just like to welcome you in to come in and stream in and to be here most of all. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. In the house of the Lord there is freedom. In the house of the Lord there is love, peace, joy, and happiness in the house of the Lord. Our scriptural reading will be coming from the book of chapter 59 of Psalm, that first through the fifth verse. And to identify ourselves, we over here at 4240 9th Avenue North, First Baptist Church of Kingston, where our pastor is the pastor, T.N. Miller. Amen?
Amen.
Psalms 59, the first through the fifth verse. And when you have found it, please stand in reverence of God's word. A psalm of David. Deliver me from my enemies, O my God. Defend me from them that rise up against me. Deliver me from the workers of iniquity, and save me from bloody men. For lo, they lie in wait for my soul. The mighty are gathered against me, not for my transgression, nor for my sin, O Lord. They run and prepare themselves without my fault. Awake to help me, and behold, thou therefore, O Lord God of hosts, the God of Israel, awake to visit all the heathens. Be not merciful to any wicked transgression. Selah. You may have your seat. Let us go to the throne of grace. Man need to always pray and faint not.
Of your heart and mind.
do something this morning. I don't normally do on celebration, but it's an old song, say, give it my flowers. While I get here, so that I, the beauty that they bring. He went on to say, speak kind words to me when I hear it. I'm going to do something today that I've never done before in a long time. I'm going to go to funerals. I'm going to ask if there'll be one besides Sister Jesse Shepherd. And if anybody knows the story of Jesse, Jesse is a walking miracle. God said she was the chair lady for Women's Day. And God allowed her to walk in this church on that day. And she went through a lot. She went through a lot. I'm going to ask, now let me say this to you. And I'm saying it because I'm the pastor. If you got something on your shoulder that you've been trying to get off, you want to come up here on my day and make me look bad. Don't try that. If you can't say nothing nice, stay in your seat. Not nothing bad. I admit I ain't got everything right. And you ain't either. So if you live in a glass house, I'm going to go. God be the glory. I'm going to ask Jesse to come now. She's coming in her own way. And there will be two more. Only two more. And after that, we will move to our tithes and offering. And whatever you want to give, Pastor Miller, today you have these bags, you can drop it off. I want to say thank you for that. Let me say this before Jesse comes. My sidekick has been with me for a long time. He don't say much, but that's my boy. That's my son. I got some grandsons and sons here, but Jay Jordan is part of my life. He's not my biological child, but Jay is my life now. And I love him dearly. And I want you all to know. I want you to stay until my son stands up.
When the membership in the old church grew so large, that you could not expand. You couldn't go to the left because of the road. You couldn't go to the right because of the projects. You pulled the balcony all the way over the sanctuary to make room for the growing church. Then God gave you a vision to bring us here. And you built the church on this site. Your journey as a pastor all of these years have not always been easy. But through the good days and the bad days, you said, I won't complain. And you stood up. And today, I'm proud to say, like the lyrics of Dr. Puppy, you just stand. And that's what you have done. You brought the motto to this church, love is what love does. You go beyond being a pastor, brother. We need a musician, you're here. You have cooked for the needy on Sunday mornings. You have cooked for the needy on Wednesday nights. You're cooking breakfast and doing everything that you need to do. A lot of times I pull up in my car church when Reverend Miller pulled up before he even come in the sanctuary for Sunday school, he's down by the store up the street picking up trash. Because he like everything clean and in order. So a few years ago, something happened that I, and I'm sure some of the other choir members did not like. And Reverend Miller kept telling myself, as I passed by and looked, Jesse, you need to do something about that. And I never did. The years went by. But this year, after 47 years of service, I said, do it, Jesse. Because Reverend Miller, you deserve it. You deserve it. So I called the city hall, y'all. And when I wanted it. She said, somebody will be getting in touch with you. And somebody did get in touch with me. I told him what I wanted. I told him what I wanted it done. And I said, when you get through with it, cover it up. He said, Miss Jessica, I can do it. I kept at it. He said, I got you, baby. I got you. It's going to be done. Called the Thursday, baby, I got you tomorrow, like you told me on Friday. So, I came by, and I said, thank you, Lord. It's done. So I asked Ernie to take a walk with me this morning. Then I asked George to take a walk with me this morning.
Acquaintance, friends, If you consider him your friend, stand. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And I ask you to join me because I'm representing the friendships. Pastor Miller and I have been friends for 42 years. And everybody thought I was going with him, but I haven't. So no, Aston and I never dated, but I take care of him like I take care of my brothers. When we go to the National Baptist Convention, Congress, anyway, he stays in the best of hotels because of my relationship with the people at the National Baptist where I work. He's my friend. He can call me in the morning. He calls me at night. My husband say, is that you and Pastor Bill? I say, yeah. He said, go and look for me. Because he knows it's going to be a conversation. And he trusts me, and he trusts Pastor Miller. And I can truly say, you are my friend. We've been through thick and thin. You've been to places I told you you weren't going no more, and you ain't been. Walk with integrity, and you've done that. Keep yourself, you've done that. No matter what people say, because we all are something to somebody else. But when you turn the mirror around, you're looking at yourself. And if there's anybody in here that's perfect, there's anybody in here that has never done anything wrong, I want you to stand to your feet. Nobody can stand, because we've all done something. And you know what? I'm glad I'm a conversation piece. Because when y'all go home today, y'all gonna be talking about me. And that's okay. That's okay, because I know who I am. And you talk about my friend and my pastor, but he know who he is. He know who he is in the body of Christ. And if you want to know him, call him and have a conversation with him and ask him, has he been on the hill? And if he's been on the hill, don't mess with him. You know what I call the hill? Because he loves the grass. But when he goes on top of the hill, whatever problem he has, no matter what he's going through with, he gets it solved on the hill. And when he come to me and he said, well, something's going on, I said, have you been on the hill? He said, no. I said, well, go out there and get on the hill. And when he get on the hill, everything is all right, because that's him and God's meeting ground. Yes. Amen. Amen. And he's my friend. I love him.
We finished high school together. I got his lesson for him so he could finish high school. And he would tell you that. Because he was too busy doing drum major. Never knew that the day would come that he would be in the shoes that he is in now. Because if you only knew him when he was younger, you said, no way. But I say this to say this. I love him. Nothing in the world I won't do for him. And we have spent a lot of light burning at night. Even when he had problems, we prayed together. Because only God can solve them. Yeah. I was just a conversation piece. But God was in the midst. Yeah. So when you get tired of it, send him back home. Because we'll have him back.
My Lord. Thank you.
Listen out, please, Dad.
If ever we needed the Lord before, show me.
So I want to thank this, because I might forget, but before we pray, I want to thank this usher for one of the strongest usher folks in the city. And I want to thank the trustees, some of the best trustees you've ever find in our secretary. I'm grateful for that. And I'm grateful for where we are to see this in church on this Sunday. I just don't speak for Reverend Miller, it speaks for the body of you being back in church. And so I'm glad. I am okay. I want to thank you all from the depths of my heart for coming back to church. You go everywhere else, but you just need to stay in church, amen? Amen. So I'm asking now, Dr. Terrell, and I want to say that we have Reverend Carney Smith with us today, who will be bringing a message on next Sunday for the matrons. If ever you ever hear a preacher, come back and hear him. Somebody's preaching also, along with this man who will be introduced to bring the word today. We're going to ask Brother Jarrell to come and bless this offering. We're going to move into another room.
We thank you afresh, O God, for these gifts that you have given us to give back to you. We pray that, God, that you would continue to bless those who gave, those that desire to give but didn't have. May now these gifts be used for them. For your glory, your honor, and the love of your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Let me also take this moment to thank the young lady who came because I invited her some Sunday ago. In the passing of her husband, one of Birmingham best preachers, Reverend January. Sister January is in our ministry right now. We stand, Sister January. Let's give her a great big round of applause. And also, my little godson, who is one of Birmingham best musicians, also Sister Brown. I mean, you know, bless me today. You know, you play the organ. You play the organ. So, we have our own son, Bruce. Little Bruce Henderson Jr. Will you stand, Mr. Bruce? And that's another great music. As we prepare now, there is a song that we do this. I want Bruce, I want you to come here to this keyboard because that's a praise and worship song that you taught us some time ago. I want you all to listen. I want you all to do this song. I look around, I want y'all to catch up. Listen to it. I want you to come and go with us. And after that song, Reverend Billy Copeland will introduce the man, Speaker Dowd, and also let me recognize Sister Jels, will you raise hand your hand? This is Sister Jels, this is Reverend Jels. Wife and mother is here. Will you stand, both of y'all stand? And Sister Copeland, will you stand?
Thank you.
Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Oh, shut up, y'all. Glory to the Lamb. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hey! Hey! Hey!
Thank you.
Pastor T.A. Miller and the First Church celebrated 47 years. I promise you, from my schooling, Dr. Miller, they taught us stand up, speak up, shut up. Thank God for wife, mother, members of the home, Pastor Senior, Pastor Fanky, for leaving the home and coming on with us. Listen, I got one thing, I got to do this. My woman is in the house, Dr. Miller. Sweetheart Jane. She's trying to act like she don't hear me. Amen. Listen, there is a word. Churches still don't understand. You can get your search committee. You can get your resumes. You can decide who's the most educational. Who's the most important. Y'all can compare with me. And when voting time, that you have voted your man. But when your man don't turn out to be your man, you'll turn around and start praying to God to send you what you need. I knew it was going to be quiet in here. But the Bible said, I will give you pastors.
That's what it says.
Before you ever thought about it, he already had 10
in mind. And probably some of you probably said he wasn't your king. And you said he wouldn't have made it. Y'all can say amen. But 47 years later, look like he's still God's man. Because when God gives the pastor, God make ways that you can't see. So when God gives you a gift, you ought to know how to treat the gift. Let me bring you just a little bit closer before I get to God's gift. When individuals turn around and give you something you didn't deserve in return of receiving the gift that you didn't know you was going to get, I think it's in order to turn around and say thank you. And for 47 years, God gave First Baptist a gift to bring you off of one corner to put you on another corner and look at you.
Yeah.
Look, this is the word of God.
That's all.
I just told the hope this morning.
before. You got some folks in here jealous. They ain't got what you got.
Yeah.
Jealousy will hinder God's business. And I need some of y'all to know some of these folks in here don't like you. Because you love your pastor.
That's right.
But I'm glad I looked at this text. I passed it, and I went on to the I. Because that question, somebody need to know who the I is. The I is the one said in the beginning. They said, let the hell. I is the one said, let us. I is the one said, I'm a jealous God.
Yeah.
speak of compassion. But then I got to get out of here. How to treat a gift. You all show love to God's gift.
Come on now.
Yes, sir.
Oh yeah. Y'all not know God gave a gift.
Yes, sir.
One better than any of us. Because the Bible said, greater love no man than this. That a man will lay down his life. Then he said, God so loves that he gave. He gave us a gift. So my beloved First Baptist, you ought to thank God for the gift. Then I'm finished, Dr. Miller, because the text says, not only would I give you a pastor, but then he said, the pastor would be according to my heart.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
And that's the reason.
That's the reason.
I'm talking about me now.
Go ahead.
That's the reason I still put up with some folks. Because I got the love of God.
Yes, sir.
Can I help y'all? That's why God put up with all of us. Because of his love. Go on, my associate minister, Minister Grant, stand up where they can see you, baby. Listen, she'll tell you herself. She had told me, she said, Pastor, you're a good one. I told her the reason I can make it.
Yes, sir.
Is because I know who I am.
Yeah.
And then I know whose I am.
Yes.
that the wages of sin is death.
Yeah.
the God of eternal life.
Yes, sir.
I'm sure the gift in 47 years have tried to tell you to confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead. Thou shalt be saved.
Yes,
I'm pretty sure the gift tried to tell you in 47 years. The Lord is our shepherd. Yeah.
when you know what you do. When you know who you know.
Yeah.
Oh.
Thank you.